In our previous classes, we learned about a lot of different things that motion has to offer. We worked on keyframes, which are very essential when you want to animate or do some effects within the motion or any other software. The principles are the same. It's just that the interface will be a little bit different. We also worked on how we can import, save, and organize our projects. We built 2D animation projects, some simple small videos that we worked on. We worked on lights, how you can manipulate the environment using lights, different colors, and how they will look. We also tracked a few objects within our video and created some beautiful animation out of that also. We learned about cameras, which are very interesting and very super useful feature that we can actually use. In this final class, we are going to take a look at all those things and try to create our final project and bring it out as exported video. And if you are working on this, if you have been following these videos and you're finally here, I would recommend and encourage you to actually share your final project with other students who are going to get inspiration and learn from what you have done. I am going to import a video in this one. Let me just work on this. This is the video that we built. Okay, it has lights, it has the video that we want to actually work on. You can see that this is where the plane comes in. I actually want to track this airplane like we did in our previous video when we were doing tracking. I want to track this and have a dialogue box on top here and then use a camera to zoom in and track our airplane as it goes in its space. So I want to actually do that. I hope we will be able to actually achieve that in this particular video. So let's see what we have. The first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to get organized and I'm going to rename this group as airplane. Okay, I'm going to create a new group and I'm going to name that elements. Let's see, elements. And then I am going to make another group called cameras. Okay. Let's click on elements and let's build our elements. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come here to shapes and create a rectangle. Again, you may not have the same default color that I have, but once you click on the rectangle, you will need to go to properties, shape, and then you will be able to actually see. So I don't want the outline and I want the fill color to be somewhere like that. Maybe a very fancy yellow. Okay with that. I'm just gonna take this yellow and put it here in my canvas. It's easy for me to choose and pick colors if I wanna draw something else also. Great. Next thing I wanna do is I want to put in text. Let's click on text. Click on this yellow portion or anywhere on the screen. Let's say our pilot is trying to say hello to us. I'm going to increase the size of this hello and press escape. Now I can move this here. I want to change the color for this, so I'm going to click on hello, click on text and appearances here, and you will have the face. So let's click on face and maybe I want something dark like that. Okay, hello, done. Great. Next thing I want to have is a line. Okay. My line is default to this color. Again, you can click on line depending on what color you have. I'm going to click on the width here and make it as thin as possible. And then click on the color. Remember, we chose a palette here. We filled this palette. So I'm going to just choose that yellow color. Close this and now we have this. On our timeline, you can actually see that all these elements appear after a certain time. So I'm gonna select all of them and move them to the very beginning of our timeline like that. Okay, so they will appear. Now what I wanna do is I actually want to add some trackers. So let me just disable the group that I made, elements, so we don't get to see that. I want to click on the plane video and this time I'll analyze its motion. So click on behavior, motion tracking, and analyze motion that we have. Okay, I'm gonna go back where the plane actually enters, like somewhere here. Now my playhead is here and that is where the plane is coming. I will move this tracker and put it on top of maybe the windows somewhere here. And you can see the preview here where the tracker would be. Let's click on analyze. If it skips, I'm gonna have to tell, let's see what we have. It's tracking, so far it looks good. Looks good. Now the thing with this motion tracking is that you can actually use this feature for a lot of different things, right? Depending on how large your project will be, it will actually track this for you. And you know, there are a lot of fancy things you can do. The limitation is only your imagination. You are able to do a lot of things here with motion tracking. This feature is available in other softwares. Also, this is how you do it in Motion, Apple Motion software, and I feel that it's very intuitive and it's very easy to do. And I think after you do a couple of these projects, when you're doing motion tracking, you will be able to use this the way you actually want to. Okay, so now we are almost done. Great. So it has made these keyframes for us until here. Awesome. Great. Now let's click on the video and we have this motion path analyzed for us. Let's rename this to flight path for airplane. Okay, now we named this motion path, this area, as flight path airplane. Great. Now what we want to do is let's bring back our elements. Great. I want to match this to this. I want this rectangle to follow this flight path. How do we do that? I click on the rectangle and click on behaviors, and now I'll be going into motion tracking and match move. Okay, once I click that, you will see that in our inspector pane under behavior, we will get this option where we need to choose which path you want to follow. So I'll just choose flight path airplane. Great. Now it is going to follow our airplane whenever. So let's say the airplane starts here and I'm gonna bring my rectangle somewhere here. You can see the motion match move is attached to it. So let's see what we get. I want this to be closer to the airplane, so I'm gonna click on the rectangle and move it somewhere here. Okay, that's great. All right. Okay, let's move our playhead. So there you go. You can see that it's being tracked. Okay, now I want to put hello. I also want to use hello as motion path. I'm going to click on hello, motion track, and match move. And what it does is that it actually matches its movement with the rectangle. So it's automatically following the rectangle that we have, right? So all you need to do is you need to click on this hello part here and then put it somewhere in the center like that. It will remain in this area. And then we can just match this to the length here. And now you can see we've got our plane, which the pilot is saying hello. Now we do the same thing with our line. Let's bring our line in the same duration. Click on our line and click on motion track, match move, and it automatically tracks that to our hello, but we need to move it so that we can get close to the airplane. Okay, this looks good. Now you can see once our animation begins, we are tracking this, it's going really well. Now, it's going all the way here, and this is where I want it to end. So now you can see that the hello does not make sense, it's leaving the frame, so that is where I want this to end. So what we'll do is we'll go in and we will, okay, another thing that you can actually do is you can click on the element and press O and it's going to cut everything. So it's out point. So that's the in point and this out point. You can do the same thing here and press O and it will cut everything that is behind. So this is where, until this area, I want this to happen. So I can do the same thing here for my rectangle and that's it. So now we get the plane and then boom, message is gone and then the plane leaves. Okay, But what I want is, when the plane is somewhere here, I want the camera to actually zoom in and then follow the plane as it's leaving, and then zoom out so that we can see our animation studio. Let's see how we can do that. Like, let's, another thing, you also have the groups option here. You can always zoom them in and out so that you can actually see. So now what I want to do is I want to add a camera. Let's click on our group and bring in a camera. So we need to switch this to 3D. You can see our camera is here. I want to create a position here. So I will be creating a position for, I will be creating a keyframe for position and rotation here, and that is where we start. You can see the diamond appearing, and then we go all the way here. I'm leaving the camera as it is. Now, as this plane enters this area, I want another keyframe here, and maybe let's move a little bit more. And now I want to use this zoom feature here, and zoom all the way here, and we can see this. Maybe I also want to add this here. Okay, great. Now we have actually zoomed in like that, and now the plane is here until here. I will create another keyframe here and here, so we know that from here to here it is going to stay in this position. Now, a few frames later, I'm going to create another keyframe. Now, this keyframe is to lock this position. And now, from here, all the way, to this place, I want to track this. What I want is, I want the camera to follow. So I chose this place here, somewhere here. And now I'm going to use this feature and actually track the plane as it goes. Okay, let's see what we have. So we zoom in like that, and now we are tracking the plane in its area. Okay, now that has happened, I'm going to make another keyframe in this area, and then maybe go a little bit further, and I'm gonna go back here to the center like that and use this zoom out feature and go all the way to the outside. There you go. So now you can see, if I play my animation, so we've got our plane coming in. And then we added another keyframe where it zooms in like that, and then keyframe where it actually follows. And then we zoom out like that. Great. Now you can see that we've added all these things, and then it goes out like that. And that is our animation. There you go. So I'm just going to end this somewhere here. So I'm going to bring our cursor from this area to where our animation actually ends. So there you go. So we've added cameras. We added an airplane. You can see the airplane is actually moving. Now this was done on the video itself. We exported this video before, and then we added this tracker where we can actually see what's happening. So maybe what I want to do is, you see this, it's really nice, just zooms in and zooms out like that. It's really, really fancy and amazing to actually. Let's try to add something else. Remember we made that rocket that we were working on? So let's bring that rocket in and see if we can actually use that to animate in this area. So I'm going to create a new group, and this group would be called, let's say, Rocket. And I am going to maybe bring the rocket somewhere here, where it zooms out. This is the area where I want the rocket animation to start. So I'm gonna click on import. Now this is the rocket that we are going to work on. The rocket layer is somewhere here. So let's move this rocket to this place. This is where I want the rocket to appear in the last few places. Okay. Now let's change the size by pressing the shift key. Change the size of this rocket somewhere here. Now what I want is, I want this rocket to actually start somewhere here, which we have, and go in, click on this rocket there, click on properties, click on position, and then we go all the way here, and I want this rocket from this place. Okay, let me just go in to go all the way up like that. We zoom in, zoom out, and we can see the rocket is going up like that. We can add a few more elements to this rocket. Let's go into our library and maybe let's go to particle emitters and look for match burner. Okay, great. We can apply this here in this area, and let's see how we can work on this. That's our rocket moving. So I want this to follow our rocket. So I'm gonna start somewhere here. I'm gonna bring this somewhere here. Remember, we can rotate. Okay, I'm gonna attach this to the rocket like that. And now when the rocket is moving, I want it to have its path also moved. So I'm gonna go into inspector, go to properties, and create a motion path for it. So as it's going, our rocket is leaving, I want it to So now we have our, I've set this path for our matching burn. So now this is what our final video looks like. So let's see what we get. So we've got our light animation studio. We've got our plane, which is actually being tracked with a message from the pilot that is saying hello. And then we have a camera that zooms in, and the camera starts to track the airplane in its space. And when the airplane reaches a certain place, it leaves that, comes out, and we are able to actually see the rocket animation that is actually going all the way up. It's an amazing tool that you can actually work on, and these are some beautiful ways of how you can actually use motion. And depending on the power of your PC or when, which year you're actually working, I'm recording this in 2021, September 2021, and you should be able to do a lot of things within motion software, and it is a great way. This was all the things that I wanted to discuss in this basic animation and motion interface, basic introduction to motion class, and I hope you enjoyed this. If you've finished your class projects, I'd encourage you to actually share them so that other people can actually learn from you. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.